司理杨素斌是 YTL 杨忠礼企业集团总经理，他从1978年进入父亲集团工作，到接下发展重任，几年间将集团发展成跨国及跨界的国际企业，不但在马来西亚拥有两座私人投资的发电厂，在英国也拥有一家自来水与发电公司，而澳洲的南澳地区电力供应全来自他的事业。事业有成的杨素斌更在2010年荣获奥斯陆商业促进和平奖的唯一华裔得奖者，刚获奖的他被主办单位形容是具有愿景的领导人，尤其是在推动商业道德操守的卓越表现。
Ladies and gentlemen, first and foremost, allow me to give all honor and glory to my Lord Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. From himI derive my purpose and passion to be a salt of the earth and a light of the world.
而这一个在亚洲企业具有举足轻重的人物，却总将一切的荣耀归给上帝。
今天的真情部落格非常的特别，我们的来宾是在亚洲企业界里面是相当具有影响力的一位杨素斌，他的杨忠礼企业包括了在澳洲、在印尼的电力公司，还有在最近几年在英国的水利公司。那么同时呢，他还有饭店，还有餐厅，可以说是不止在亚洲，在全世界都是相当具有影响力的一个人。让我们一起来欢迎 Dancery Francis。
你好
，We'd like to say welcome to Taiwan. You have a very close linkage to Taiwan, right? Because your grandfather.
Yes, my grandfather. In fact.And my grandmother come from Chinmen. So, yes, so,、
wow.
yeah, so we are more linked to Taiwan than people know.
Your family business is very, very successful. When you were 16, however, there were some difficulties at home.
Yes, the crisis was because of the oil crisis. In those days, when you do a construction project,、mm-hmm. your profit is hardly 5%. And the oil prices, because in 1971, 73,There were two serious oil crises,、mm-hmm. and the price of oil went double. So there's no way you could protect the materials to go up in price to be、mm-hmm. double.、Mm-hmm. So we nearly went bankrupt、mm-hmm. before when I was 16. So I remember quite a difficult period、uh-huh. that all will be lost.
And what made you to go into the church and to find God?
At that time, I didn't believe in Jesus,、mm-hmm. but the pastor...I told the problem to the pastor、mm-hmm. and the pastor said, you know, something, if you come to Christ, I believe Christ can solve your problem, but you have to come to Christ first.、Mm-hmm. And I said, okay, if this God is so powerful, if he can solve my problem, I'll believe him.
And then you believe that, what yeah, he said to you?
Yeah, so he said he took me to the sinner's prayer and I said all the sinner's prayer.And then that was a problem I have on the church was on Friday, and on the Sunday, the problem was solved.
That's
and that's when I found the power of God.
However, you grew up in a very traditional family, right?
Yes.
Did your family accept your Christianity?
In fact, I was a secret Christian for a while. Because I'm the 20th generation of the Yeo family,、mm-hmm. and I'm the eldest son.
Oh.
So it's very, so the elder son is supposed to continue the tradition of the family and to worship idols. Pai Pura, you know. So when I was 16, although I believe in Christ and I know the power of Christ, I could not share with them because I was afraid, you know, that they would get very upset and all of these feelings. But when I was 30 years old, after I married, 2 years after my marriage, I felt I must tell my parents because I'm not going to allow my children to pray the idols anymore. So I told my parents the truth that I'm a Christian. But my parents were very upset. They almost want to throw me out. They call a meeting of all my brothers and sisters and say, here's your taka, you know. How can he be so bad? You know, and they were crying, they were angry. How can he go and worship a white man's God? But I told my parents, be patient with me. I know God is very good. So I told my brothers and sisters, I give them a Bible. At that time was
a life affirmation Bible.
And also David Pawson's teaching. I said, you take this and you go and listen. And you challenge me that this God is not good. You go and study. My third brother and one other brother was very angry with me and studied the Bible thoroughly.
So they truly studied the Bible.
Yeah, and they really know the Bible very well because they were going to challenge me, prove me wrong. And then with David Pawson's, they're trying to prove David Pawson's teaching is nonsense. And 1 year later, both of them came to Christ. So today, of course, all my brothers and sisters and the in-laws are Christians. And my next generation, the 27 of them, are Christians. So I'm very blessed today.
Although your family didn't accept your belief in the beginning, however, the truth is, after you took over the business, you received a great blessing.
Yes.
And there's a huge change in your family business, right?
Yes. When we started in 1986, the company was hardly making a million ringgit in profit. Now the company makes 700 million net profit, 2 billion gross profit, and the turnover is 16 billion. So when people see Francis Yeo, they always want to know, you're so successful, tell me your story, your success story. I said, the most successful thing I ever do is believe in Jesus Christ. Nothing else more important. There are no other success story. That is the only success story I can share with you. Number one, because Jesus Christ teaches us to be humble and to be united. So Chinese family tend to be disunited. But for me, the spirit of unity was there because of the Lord Jesus Christ. When you have Christ, you're no longer egotistical. You know everything, that the blessing that you get from Jesus, not from yourself. The public may like to make you believe and praise you, but you know the truth. Every single thing that happened to the company, every single success, the Lord has a hand in it.
You give all the glory of your success to God, but I think many people would like to ask you, talking about your business, no matter water company or electricity industry, usually they are owned by the government.
Yes.
And how can you change it?
Actually, in Malaysia in early 90s, there was a blackout in the country. Blackout. So the government was very angry with the National Electricity Company. How can they have blackout, very inefficient? So I told the government, why don't you let the private sector? I'll fund it. I'll build the power plants. I'll own it. And I'll run it better than the way the government runs, or as good as the way the government runs. And the government took the challenge and said, okay, give it to me. And that itself is a miracle. But if you study that story, behind it are many, many miracles. How we use our own ringgit to finance it. At that time, people use Meijin to finance it, US dollars. If I use US dollars, I would be bankrupt today. Like Asia crisis, a lot of people use US dollars to finance borrowing for infrastructure business. We use ringgit. Where did that vision come from? It come from God. Use ringgit. God seems to know something is going to happen to the US dollar. We say we don't want to use US dollar. There's no logic of using US dollar. Why don't you use ringgit? Never been done before. Let's do it. We invented the first 15-year bond. Everything that we invent, listing the company 5 years ahead of schedule, everything. Came this idea come from where?
Incredible.
We always say bright ideas. God is light. Bright ideas means it comes from God because God is light. So there's so much meaning in the Lord, you know, when you look at his way and his tapestry, it's very deep and it's very beautiful.
So was your water company in UK another miracle?
Yes. At that time, when we bought the water company, we are David.我们这么小的公司 we were fighting against at that time Royal Bank of Scotland, which was the sixth largest bank.
Wow.
And Chong Kong, Li Ka Shing.
Li Ka Shing.
And then Italy, Enel Electricity, the biggest electricity in Europe.
Very challenging.
And we won the bid.So when we won the bid, the English newspaper, most of the English paper put up this sentence, who the hell is YTL? 所以很好笑。And we bought it off Enron. Enron was one of the America biggest company, brightest. And again, you see the bad values, very short term, ungodly in their ways, and they collapse. And here's a small little company, David, being able to take against the Goliath and win the water company. And then why water? Again, God's sense of humor. Jesus said, I'm the living water.So he gave us a light business and now he gave us the water business. Now you must ask me also, why are we in hotels and
restaurants?
And restaurants? Because Jesus feed the flock, 4,000 and 5,000, remember, with two bread, with five bread and two fish. We are also feeding people, also in the business. So in a way, we are doing what the Lord blessed people in every way. So we enjoy our life in this way with them.With our family, we know our purpose, to bring positive change, bring goodness to people's lives.
Have you ever made a mistake because you didn't listen to God's words?
Oh, have I made mistake because, yes, where we go into businesses, jumping into something quite quickly, thinking it can make money. Some of them from my younger brothers, you know, to just to entertain them, okay, la, just to keep, say, okay, maybe a taker will listen to them, maybe their idea is not as bad.Because if I keep saying no, no, no to every of their plans, they'll think I'm a big bully. Okay, sometimes I listen to them. This business can make money. For example, one area of mistake was to do latex glove. At one stage, Malaysia, we do latex. And we can produce latex glove and all these other things that go with latex. And that's quite easy money to make at that time. So we say, okay, let's try. Ah, that business...Because it's so easy, everybody does it.
It became
a very bad business. So we lost money in that. So now we have a museum of mistake. I have a store somewhere out of Kuala Lumpur City where I put in the store all the mistake. I call it the museum of mistake to remind ourselves when you don't walk according to God's will, that's what will happen. There are mistakes. Those mistakes that we do when you jump in quite quickly out of greed.Not thinking or out of other reason, and it's not accordance to God's will, you'll not get it. But if you walk everything and you pray in accordance to God's will, it will be very powerful.
Many family enterprises will grow into a stage where some family members would like to say, you know, to be separated from the family business. Why hasn't it happened to YTL?
That's because, like I said, this business is not ours.This business, we are just stewards. Everything belongs to God. So that is a concept. So when all my brothers and sisters understand we are stewards, we don't fight over who's cleverer, who's smarter, and this is mine and this is yours. We don't do that. We are already awesomely blessed with already honor from society, from already honoring even my father, who's not a Christian. He gets great honor because the company is so great.And the Lord already told me, be prepared. Tell the children, she's going to come to heaven with me. So one of my sons who was here was crying and said, no, not yet, ask the Lord more time. But my elder children said, I think we are ready.
的掌声欢迎我们杨弟兄跟巴牧师。
好，我很欢喜有机会来台湾的兄弟姐妹，很实力啦，要叫一个英国人欢迎我们的中国话。
今年夏天，杨素斌带着他的团队及两个孩子到台湾参加大卫鲍森牧师在台北举行的研经特会，并且拜访好消息卫星电视台。从亲子互动中可以看出他与孩子之间的亲近关系。
He's been extremely busy with work, but every night he always found the time to come back for dinner with us, and that time together to teach us and be with us and teach us about God. It was very, I'm blessed to be able to have that. I think some people have less time with their father, even though he's less busy, let's say. But my dad has been.
Every summer holiday, we go to Spain, we go to Switzerland, we're very blessed to go. And he'll sit us down, and every night we'll go through the Bible, passages of the Bible, just to learn and to talk. And it's good because it reinforces the way you think in the business world. And then you can apply these principles, you know, when you come out to work. My father used to put David Pawson, you know, the videos in the room. And all of us used to look at each other and then run away, you know, like, you know, run out of the room. But as we grew older, and we've had more challenges in life, then we started to see the passion my father had for Christ and for Jesus, and then we did it, and we learned ourselves how to wake up for church. And you know, when you're young, when you go to church, you'll be, oh, so boring, you know, don't want to go sing songs, oh, just go to sleep, you know, we don't want to go. But now is you have to go because you want to go.
在孩子的眼中，杨素斌虽然专心于事业的发展，但他却也重视家人之间的相处。也因此，当他挚爱的妻子因为癌症过世时，他也承受沉重的悲伤与心痛。而此时，信仰就是他的最大力量。
When my mom passed away, I was very worried about my dad. You know, you go back to your room and you sleep by yourself. I thought maybe I should go sleep in his room. Maybe it feels so empty. I think, oh my gosh, it's spent over 20 years together. I think it's impossible to. How do you get over someone who's with you for so long and you love so much, just being taken away? I guess without God, I don't know how Dad could have done it. He always was strong. Of course, he was upset, and you could tell. But you could tell that inside there was a strength and a solid sort of rock that he could lie on.
For us, it's losing a mum. You know, it's quite hard, it's quite difficult, but it's different from losing your life partner or your wife. So I always told my dad, you know, as we're hurt to lose mum, but we really, I can't feel the same way you feel. He was very hurt, but the thing that amazed me about my dad and the thing that taught me a lot about Jesus is the way he accepted, and he taught us how to accept it too.
I think you emphasize on the family value very much.
Yes.
So let's talk about your family.
Right.
Your lovely wife.
Yes.
She was a very famous artist in Hong Kong in 70s, right?
That's correct.
I'm curious, how did you two meet?
She came to Malaysia.
Oh.
She came to Malaysia on a Ding Tai.
Ding Tai.
Yeah, 表演. And then we met. And then she fell in love with me. She has recorded this, I'd say publicly. She chased me.
Really?
Somehow, yeah, she fell in love with me.
Uh-uh.
And I fell in love with her also in a very deep way because she made me laugh so much. She's a great actress, and one of her greatest skills in acting is to mimic. She can mimic anybody, any actor or any president, she can mimic. And she makes a lot of jokes. And at that time, I was looking for a wife, and I've never had a woman make me laugh so much in my life. So in 2 weeks, I proposed to her. In 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks?
Yes. So I remember I took her to, on the way to London, we stopped in Holland, and I called her mother, and I said, I want your daughter's hand, you know? So the mother, my late wife's mother, was so happy, crying with so much joy. Oh, finally, my daughter, somebody wants. Just crying with joy. Then I called my mother, said, mother, I'm getting married. And my mother also cried, but with fear. Who is this girl? I never seen in 2 weeks she wants to marry. I never even say hello yet. And you only want to marry. Are you sure? She was crying. Don't do it. I haven't even met her. One was crying for joy. One was crying in pain. Finally, everybody cried in joy when we married. And I've got 5 beautiful children now.
Your relationship has been very strong.
Yes.
You once bought an island for her.
Yes, well, I didn't buy an island for her. When I proposed to her, I said, I will give you a gift of an island if you accept my marriage.
Oh.
And she thought it was a joke. But actually, I owned a little private island at that time. Yeah. So when she accepted the proposal, when I took her to the island, she was really quite stunned that I wasn't lying. There was an island. And this island, now we have fond memories of her. And she gave the name to this island.
It was the name.
Hang Phuc Tho, Prosperity Island.
So you two were so much in love. So I think when your wife suffered from the breast cancer since 1998, right?
Yes.
So you try all you can to help her to get the best treatment.
Yes.
In 8 years.
Yeah. 5 years after my wife went to heaven, I am still loving God. I have still so much faith and it's still well with my soul. How can this be? It means Jesus is alive and well. There is in the heart a big hole. Yes, a wife, when it is like tearing a big hole from the heart, but that hole only God can fill. And I can also share with you, before she went to heaven, how beautiful it is. The 8 years I spent with her more, and then the last few months of her life that I gave up everything. And I spent a lot of time talking to her and being with her 24 hours a day. And really it's amazing how the Lord gives me gifts of time with her. I asked the Lord a bit more time because, you know, I knew the children were having exams. Some of my children were having exams, and I didn't want to call them back and tell them that how serious that the mom is. They may be distracted from the exams and all that. So I asked for the Lord's understanding and mercy and grace to keep this away from them. So keep the mother in hospital, but if Rose have to depart much earlier, I would have to call them back. So actually the Lord kept her for many months. And one of the most fascinating things which my children can share with you is the peace that Rose found with God in the last months of her life. The complete peace, no pain, and the joy and the peace. And I know that she's very peaceful. And there was one evening, I remember, when all the children had come back from the exams and all that. She was still a couple of months before she went to heaven. And I remember it was August 5th. And it was a Friday. And the Lord already told me, be prepared. Tell the children, she's going to come to heaven with me. So that night, I got the children and I said, the Lord has spoken. We have to be prepared. So are we ready for mom to go? So one of my sons who is here was crying and said, no, not yet. Ask the Lord more time. No matter how, give us a bit more time. And then another auntie was also asking for more time. But my elder children said, I think we are ready. you know. So when we went back to the hospital, minutes later, she went to heaven.
Actually, God had done something for you to prepare your heart by a song, right?
Absolutely. It's well with my soul. Every time, as you know, in history, when we won the Wessex Water, we wanted to thank God. And through a concert, the whole purpose of the concert is to thank our Lord Jesus for blessing us and also to thank the people for welcoming us. So this time I got the three tenors, Pavarotti and Carreras and Domingo, to sing this song, It Is Well With My Soul. Now, It Is Well With My Soul is a fascinating song because this is a song about an American Christian that believe in God a lot. But business went down in Chicago because of the fire. And sent the wife and the four daughters for a short break to go and join Moody's preaching in England. And on the way there, the ship sank. And the wife wrote a telegram, saved but alone. She lost four daughters in the sea. So when he went back to fetch his wife, halfway through the ocean, he asked the captain, where was it that the daughters was lost? So the captain said, around this area, at this part of the sea. He was sad, but he went down to the cabin and he read the Bible and he read Isaiah chapter 66, when peace like a river attended my way. Well, he wrote, It's Still Well With His Soul. After losing four daughters, it's still well with my soul. So I find that, wow, you know, what a story. It fascinates me. I was crying and I said, I got to get these three tenors to sing this song to remind people. And when I do that at that time, I pray to the Lord that I hope the Spatfords who wrote this song, that their descendants are also Christians. I look for them in the internet and find them, and I was praying, I hope they never lose the faith that the great-great-grandfather wrote this song. And 3 days later, again, all this happened 3 days, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I wrote on Sunday, came a reply from an American branch of the Spatford family and said, yes, you can have the rights to this song. I'm very glad the three tenors want to sing this. Yes, second part of the question, we are Christians, we have a house, looking after children in Israel, very, very alive and well, our faith in Jesus is still very intact. And then the third part is, as for your invitation to come to the concert in Bath, we cannot make it because we have to go to Israel, but my cousins in Bath wants three tickets. Can you imagine I do a concert in Bath to honor the Spatford, and one of Spatford's great-great-great-granddaughter is the Lady Cope of Bath, in Bath. You just think of God's tapestry, of how beautiful to honor Spatford and the children in that way. So that night, when you sing, if you see the tape, you will see my wife was crying
she's
a lot.
So moved, right?
She was so moved by the song because she knows the story. And of course, Lady Cope was there at my side. We were crying a lot. But I didn't know the Lord was also preparing me, because 2 years later, Rose went to heaven. I absolutely love the story of Spatford. I say, absolutely so. I can tell people's story and share. But the Lord, what about you? Right. If it really happened to you, will you be able to say, like I am telling you today, It is well with my soul. Amanda, it is well with my soul.
Another beautiful thing is, after your wife left, your relations with children grew stronger and stronger, right?
Yes. My wife is such a great mother. And because one of the fears of a father is when there's a gap, when she's such a great mother. And I think I'm an inadequate mother. I'm a great father, I think, but an inadequate mother. So I try to do what a mother normally do, to remember their birthdays, which normally a mother does.
Right.
And then I remember one occasion shortly after she passed away, and I was SMSing to all my children, remember one of the children's birthday. And you know what? All the children said to me, Dad, we know, we already know that you are the last. So they were already playing mother to each other.
Oh,
and I think that's why I am comforted, because again, they are brought up with God and the Lord Jesus fills their heart. It's much easier for me because they understand and they also help me. They are also mothering me now. Instead of me mothering them, they are mothering me. So I felt sometimes they act as a mother to me and try to look after me like my wife. So in a way, yes, I think it's beautiful. If I see my children such beautiful act of love, I'm enriched by that. We are going to do a three tenors concert in Bath. So, but my father was saying, my son, you know, one tenor Pavarotti is £1 million, you know?
Wow.
They only want Pavarotti, why you have to add two more? That means we have to spend £3 million.
在英国古迹广场举办的世界知名三大男高音演唱会，这不是商业演出，而是杨素宾回馈当地民众的一番心意。不同于一般企业家，杨素宾乐于与人分享他的企业所得。
Thank you very much, Colin. Wattiel's concert of celebration is a journey of thanksgiving to the community at large and to God especially.Therefore, tonight, I would like to offer thanksgiving to the gifted people.
而举办世界级的演唱会，并开放一般民众免费入场，就是他分享爱与尊荣上帝的时刻。
Guardiu al vento, muta l'accento e di pensier.
2010年，他同样也在新加坡植物园举办安德鲁·珀切利的露天音乐会。取之于社会，用之于社会，坚持以基督信仰来经营企业的原则，是杨素宾为孩子们立下的重要人生榜样。
He'll always want 100% focus on what we're doing, on whatever we're doing, andWell, whatever industry he puts us in, he'll always want us to give 100%. If we're not giving 100%, if we only give 50%, he'll say, don't do it. You know, don't waste my time. You know? Because you have to, because you're put into a family business where you have to prove to the other people around you, you're not just a yang, you're not just a yo. You are your own person and you have to fly by yourself. I'm so happy that my father is a Christian.I'm so happy that he introduced the whole family to Christ. I'm so happy I'm a Christian. But bar the Christian life, there's also the family life, which he takes very, very importantly. He brought us, he taught us a lot of lessons in respect, loyalty, love, caring for one another.
My father's a great businessman. I have a lot of You know, my brothers, I got two brothers older than me. We have big shoes to fill. And I suppose that could drive us to sort of be like him and do well and be smart and be a good businessman. But that's never what he wanted for us. I mean, not that he doesn't want us to be like that. He always stresses that being a good Christian, believing in Jesus, living a good life is the most important thing.
The Lord of Jesus is so faithful to you, and sometimes he has done such cute things, like when you invited the three tenors to go to UK to have a concert, right? You spend a lot of money, and you invited the residents for free.
That's right.
And people think you are crazy, right?
That's correct. And let me tell you another funny story. So when we wanted to thank God and the people, so I told the British, all the managers and all my staff, I'm going to give you the best of the British, Russell Watson, Catherine Jenkins, Royal Philharmonic. And you know what they say? These are English people. It's boring. We are English. We don't need more English singers. So I said, really? I want to honor the English and you find them boring? I said, who do you want? They said, can you bring your good friend Pavarotti? I said, okay, let me call him. And then something struck me. And I said, Pavarotti, well, why don't I do the three tenors and do the whole hawk, you know? If I'm going to do a concert and it's such a great celebration, why not do it? And they're not getting young, Pavarotti and the two other tenors. So I told Pavarotti to call the two others to come. And they both, and they all agreed to come. So when they agreed to come, I told my family, I have a family meeting, good news, we are going to do a three tenors concert in Bath. So, but my father was saying, I was Tucker, no, my son, you know, one tenor Pavarotti is £1 million, you know.
What?
They only want Pavarotti, why you have to add two more? That means we have to spend £3 million, right? Why? It's a lot of money. And then one of my younger brother, who's also a Christian, but also not that strong faith at that time, was saying, Father is right. Why don't you have just one? After people say we'll show off with our money and all that, you know, why three? Just so the conversation was going a bit wrong. And I told them, I look at my brother who's a Christian. Don't you know Jesus is paying the bill? Then he shut up. Okay. So he kept quiet. So when all my brothers agree, my father have to agree. So the story stopped. So we did a three tenors concert. And when I say Jesus paid the bill, Jesus really paid the bill. When Pavarotti asked for, when we want to do the concert, the only date Pavarotti had was August the 7th. And August month in Bath is always the wet month. Always the most wet. We are in the water business,
right,
so we know.
Right.
But that's the only date he has with the three tenors. And we want to do this concert in the open, you know, free for people. So if it rains, it will not be good. So all my brothers will always tell me, but you know, the date is wrong. Even my managers, you know, can we get Pavarotti change the date? And you know, I look at them, I say, ye of little faith. God will never rain on his own parade. Since the first day I invited Pavarotti and all the singers to sing, to thank God, it has never rained. Never. And guess what happens? That month of August, that period, was once in 60 years the heat wave. Hottest month ever in the history, once in 60 years, heat wave in Britain. And because of the heat wave, a lot of people drink more water. And you know, we made £3 million more profit because they drank more water. And that's why Jesus paid the bill. It's £3 million for that concert. Exactly, Tiffany.
So why is it that when you have something, especially one thing, God, and you will help the concerts, right? People think that's a marketing thing. But you didn't think so, right?
I do it because I want to share God's goodness. And God's goodness come in many ways. One of them is through songs and music. If you look at opera and all the song, Panis Angelicus, Bread of Heaven. Who is Bread of Heaven? Jesus Christ. Many songs were dedicated to God. Bach's songs. If you look at all the great music, were all dedicated to God. And that's how it's God breath. Like, the Bible is God breath. Music, God breath are the most beautiful. And actually opera is the apogee, is the highest of God's glory. To sing and praise God.
Mm-hmm.
That would be a great thing. Like, It's Well With My Soul sung by the three tenors. Isn't that amazing? So I think one of the greatest gifts of God is music. And if we share music with people, I love that because it shows God's greatness in a different way.
Mm-hmm.
One of the most amazing things, I still get letters from people thanking me.
Oh, really?
Up to today from that concert. So it has an indelible experience to many people.
Oh.
But one letter that I got was the most touching. And this was a lady that wrote to me and said, "Dear Francis, I got your address. I hope you don't mind, from your office in Wessex. And I just want to tell you that you gave a heaven on earth moment in Bath, and I'll never forget it. I know what heaven is like and how beautiful it is. If it can be this beautiful in the concert, heaven must be more beautiful.
Wow.
I look forward to chatting with you sometime soon." So, okay, I said, well, the next time I go to Bath, I must look for this woman and talk to her. But I understand 2 weeks later she went to heaven. This was her last letter.
Wow.
You know, to say, she was telling me she's ready to go to heaven because of the concert. And she tasted God and the goodness of God.
Right.
And she's ready to go. She was just trying to share
right.
with me.
Right.
And
right.
I was very, very touched by that letter.
So you invited your another friend, Andrew Pacelli, to hold a concert in Singapore for free again.
All concerts are for free because God pays the bill. Again, Andrea Bocelli is a great friend. And again, if you look at tapestry of God, if you were attending a pop concert like Andrea Bocelli, who's got millions of fans, you would just say that was fantastic, good or bad, I enjoyed it, and then. But when the Lord's hand is in the concert, it touches people. I cannot explain that, but I can feel just like Bath. When God is present, emotionally and the soul get touched very deep, whether a believer or not. If you're a believer, more. But if you're not a believer, even you will be touched that there's something beautiful about God. This is the first time that I felt Jesus. I felt the pleasure of Jesus. He was pleased with me. It's almost like Eric Liddell, when he runs, he says he feels God's pleasure when he runs. You know that Eric Liddell? That night I felt God's pleasure in the concert. I felt God's pleasure. He was happy.
In Singapore and Indonesia, people believe in all kinds of religions.
That's right.
And you raised the name of Jesus in public.
Yes.
Were you worried that that might influence your business?
Absolutely not. I never will apologize for the name of Jesus Christ. Why should I? Here's the truth.
For sharing the blessings that you got from the Lord of Jesus, you spent 20 years preaching to some fishermen in a small
yes,
village.
Yes, I asked the Lord, I said, I want to build a church on this island. The Lord said there's no need to build a church on this island called Pangkolan. But go to the fisherman's island. I want you to build a church there. So that was in 1985, early days. So my burden was to build a church. And I financed so many programs, financed pastors, money, bring big churches, people, plant. They keep collapsing. When the church started, for almost 20 years, there were only five people in the church. The pastor and the wife, and then the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. There's nobody attending the church. One day, I have a flock of my friends who came to Christ, and some of them are here with me, and they are crooks. They are loan sharks people, people who beat people up, gangsters, you know, all sorts of very bad people. All Xia Hui Lang. Oh, Chopai. And they came to Christ through my preaching of love of Jesus. That Jesus will never, Jesus came because this Pai Lang. That's why Jesus came to save you. And this is a very powerful people in the sense that their lives change. From a loan shark, they become good people. That in itself makes people laugh at them, and there's a very powerful testimony already. And God said, bring these people that you love. And these people knows about love because they came to Jesus through love. Bring these people and go to the fishing village and talk to them. No need of pastors, no need of theology. That day somehow, I spoke in tongue, in Hokkien. I do not need the interpreter, I just spoke. Kong Hokkien way. Kai kong anzo ya so jin tia ni. Anzo ya ko jin tia dia hu ye lang. Why I told them about Sea of Galilee. So I told them, without knowing, for 25 minutes I was speaking in Hokkien. And ya so chok tia ni. You know? And I thought, and then, many people came to Christ because of this love and the testimony from all these loan sharks. And they were telling the story how they came to Jesus. And today, the church, today, have 800 people.
I think I'm so blessed today to listen to so many interesting and amazing stories. Before we finish the lesson talking, is there anything else you want to share to our audience?
Guna kong masih kim menang.
Hey, yo.
Kim menang, tong kim wat di dijap itai dah.二十七的，
是台湾人啦，
还是新金门人、台湾人？我相信耶稣了，我希望咱台湾啊，耶稣足听咱台湾人，希望大家有一个机会听到咱东京 this interview， and then maybe 想一想，我们的耶稣是很好的 ，maybe go to church， read the Bible。Study, maybe the challenge, whether it's true like my brothers. But I just want to say, Jesus is so good, and I cannot keep it for myself. I have to share it. And I hope all the Taiwanese people will be blessed to come to the Lord Jesus to be saved and enjoy His love and His glory with Him.
真的是很有趣哦，电力公司是给光，水利公司是给活水。餐厅饭店是可以用五饼二鱼喂饱五千人的故事。今天在杨素斌的故事里面，你听到了什么呢？很多人问他什么是成功，坚持努力让事业能够蒸蒸日上，然后可以获利，这是成功没有错。但是还有其他的，杨素斌要告诉你，就是要坚持信仰的原则。他看过太多的人，人性是贪婪的，当你有钱之后，你还会想要更有钱。当你为了想要更有钱再去努力追求所谓的成功的时候，你就变得很贫穷了，因为你实在就不知道你努力的目标是什么。那么真正的成功和富足是什么呢？杨素斌说，就是要让神来你的生命中掌权，让神在你的生命中掌权。他的故事，这一位在亚洲最有影响力的企业，全球最有影响力的人物之一，希望能够给你一些启示。
I am still quite young. I'm not as wise as him or not as smart as him as yet, but I will get there. And he wants us all to surpass him in the future. But right now, I will say that I love you very much, and I will continue to grow and learn in the way that God wants me to through you and with Jesus teaching me.And I'm very, very proud of everything you've done and everything Jesus has done through you.
I think he's a great, great father, and keep up the good work.
各位好，我是你们的老朋友孙悦。这位南都丹斯里杨素斌这位弟兄真的很有意思，他让我想到圣经里面的故事。这个耶稣做了一个比喻，说一个主人他要到外国去啊，然后把他自己的财产交给他几个仆人，让他们来帮着经营。第一个因为按着能力来，第一个就给了他五千两银子，第二个给了两千两，第三个就一千两。最后当主人回来的时候，那个得到五千两银子的那个仆人呢，就拿五千两做生意，又赚了五千两。主人说啊，你这个又良善 啊，又忠心的仆人。好，你在小事上忠心，在大的事情上更会忠心。我要交给你很多的事情，让你管理，你也可以进入到我这里，跟我一起来享受欢乐。从这里我们可以看到了，真的，我们这位杨弟兄，他忠心于自己的这个神，不管是他在生活、在家庭、在教育、在自己的事业上，一切都是这样子。那么当他遇到了一些生意或者是在人际上有抵触的事情，完全以圣经为依据。亲爱的朋友，我相信我们在企业界也有一些朋友是基督徒，我们借着我们这位这个丹斯里啊，杨素斌弟兄他的这个榜样，我们一起来学习一下，我们也为你祷告。慈爱的主耶稣，在这里我们除了为我们的杨弟兄祷告以外，我们也为在电视机前面所有的弟兄姊妹祷告，求主你让他们在每一件事上都对主忠心。当自己在生活困难或者是事业上遇到抵触的时候，一切以主为中心。主啊，真的求你给我们力量，帮助我们，让我们学习怎么样成为一个好仆人。恭敬的祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名，阿门。亲爱的朋友，其实很简单，你看到了吗？杨素斌弟兄他就是用这种方法。哎，开始好像还觉得人家不太接受，日久天长大家觉得他就是一个表里如一的人。朋友，我们为了达到我们自己的目的，或者是建立我们自己人际关系，我们并不是表里如一。让我们学习以主为主，以主的心意为我们的心意。上帝赐福你。